I'm trying to think what they were. There's four things that needed to be addressed. One of them was the science labs. One of them was they want a common planning time, which I've done the best I can with common planning time.
This is the letter, but again, yeah. I don't want to put you on.
No, that's right. That's right. Yeah. That'll just help me look at it. Yeah. No, that's right.
I think I just want to tell you that we're going in the right direction because we still have some hurdles, but.
Yep. So basically, there's four things that I still need to address. One is the science labs, as I said. The other is provide appropriate technology support staff, so they're looking for like a technology integration person that would work for teachers and students to kind of make sure that everybody's using technology appropriately and so forth. The other one is to implement the formal process for the 21st century learning skills. We already have that in development. I should have that done by the end of this school year. And the other one is to establish a formal opportunities for faculty to engage in professional discourse. That's the common planning piece. The best I could do with the schedule that we have right now is the core content areas. I have a period off, so the math department all has the same period off that they can work together. The science department has a period off and so forth. But that's only for the four major areas. I don't have common planning time for what I call the encore areas, the areas that are not core, and they don't meet at the same time. They all have their own individual common planning. That apparently is not satisfactory to them, so I'm looking at other options now.
Great, thank you very much. Is there anything we can do to when you think about, I mean, I don't want to sign up your agenda properly, but do you think about any ways that we can help you maybe at the next meeting?
Yeah, like I said, there's four areas that need to be addressed. Three of them have to do with finances. One of them I can take care of before the end of the year. So.
Great.
All
right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hard work. Does anybody have any questions in that area? Let's move on to full business. Let's talk about the fiscal year 17 budget surplus. Marie asked for this to be put on the agenda. I know standing on you, but she specifically asked for this. Do you have any questions, Marie, or would you want?
No, I just wanted to know. I know there's a document in our packet that is the $353,000 figure what your anticipated surplus is for this year at this point.
Okay. Is there any questions on that?
Yes, this is Marie.
All right, fiscal year 18 operating budget. Anybody have anything?
I have something for capital budget.
Okay,
Thursday night, we have a meeting at the town, all the departments, school department, police fire, with the planning board to discuss the capital plans that we submitted to the town. The direction I want to take with this is that in the past, we would submit a list of maybe 21 projects or so, and they would review, and some things would be funded, some things wouldn't. I don't want to do that. I want to take a look at our engineering reports, the items that are flagged as priority one, priority two, tie it into the master facilities plan, and then anything we do with the town and capital improvements are all through RIDE reimbursement, approved projects, and the revolving fund. So rather than have these little onesie twosie little projects, I want to approach this holistically and go for the reimbursements and then continue to reinvest.
Guys, the whole business. This was on the last agenda. I just wanted to kind of keep moving with this. So, the establishment of a corporate sponsor and donations on programs by equipment. So, I'd like the permission of the school committee to accept donations in regards to, we'll use one specific example. Continue on multiple fronts, but the cage, the work needed for the discus cage. And I think at that point, it would be a full-fledged outdoor track field, which means that we could have home events there. The cost of it is approximately $35,000. I believe I'm subject to myself going out to the corporate sponsors and raising half of that. I'm wondering if the school committee would pay for the other half. And the other thing I want authorization to do is acknowledge who is donating. So on that, so the cage, you could say, you know, paid for by the generosity of a corporate sponsor. So I'm wondering if that is okay to go forward with, if anybody else has any ideas, whatever else we can talk about.
Share with the advertisements of these corporate sponsors, would the school committee be able to put any input in how those were presented, or would that be entirely up to the
people? My expectations, we would take the money to put it in the account, purchase the item so we got under our control, and then we would have signage put up, and maybe it's a little ceremonious, depending on how much. Thank you for the generosity of XYZ.
So we would be putting the signage in the money?
Yes.
Okay, great, thank you.
That's okay.
I just worry a little bit about having some just blatant advertisements all over certain parts of the school, I guess. It's just something that's wrong with people. If we're going to be managing how those pieces of gratitude look, then I feel better about that.
Yeah. Does anybody have any questions or concerns? Is that acceptable? Is that a good way to go?
The only thing I'd say is if you're looking at a $35,000 cage.
Yes.
So
cement.
Yeah. I'd just be careful about the wording on the sign. Construction with contributions from,
yeah.
As opposed to pay for by indicates that somebody paid for it.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think that's disingenuous to the taxpayers who are actually paying for it.
Okay.
I just don't want to.
My concern is I just want to make sure that everybody's comfortable that it's going to be some advertising in different places that maybe wasn't in. Or, but obviously, we need to be in that
point. It's really no different than what we have in the athletic field right now.
Right. Right.
I don't know. I really don't have a comment. I think I would like to know what Mr. Sagini and Mr. McGee and Mr. Shaw feel about this. This is something that we talked about years past when I go back. We never really did it to a great extent, so I'm not quite sure why that was, but how do you feel about it?
Generally, I'm comfortable with advertising on school property, but in this case, to help us move forward and provide some relief from the funding, I'd say yes.
Yeah, there are several people that actually ask to do that, and they're willing to do it. They actually get tax write-offs to do it, too. So one thing that I would suggest is just make sure we send them some sort of a thank you, and then they can use that as a documentation that they have done, and they can use it as a tax write. So it helps all of us.
We'll set up a policy. I just want to make sure that we're going to have set up some contract in theory. This is what we're doing, this is what we're offering you. And obviously, a thank you letter, and maybe a ceremony, $17,000 probably for something. Thank you for bringing it out of here.
Thanks, Mr. Chair, for what it's worth. Ask that we try and reach out to local businesses first before reaching out to larger, maybe non-personal field-based businesses.
Yeah, sure. And the only other thing is, I know I asked this, and I was looking when I initially asked, was the signage at the elementary school, and they said it's not controlled by the school. But I can't imagine that the high school, but the high school signs are not controlled by us.
Which is?
The ones, right?
And it's I'm not sure. I know that I'm not involved in it.
On the back, isn't it? The sign is.
By the track.
From the track?
Yeah.
But those are not controlled by the school.
Who
controls them?
Right.
That's the athletic association. STN, NSA.
Well, all right. So we're going to have to work with them to make sure that they're collecting proper money. I don't know if they do it on a yearly basis.
They do it on a yearly basis. And those who advertise, who choose to advertise, renew. And they work with a local printing company here in town to generate those signs. And they use that money essentially is reinvested into athletics.
I'm okay with that. I just want to make sure that that's happening. I know that the signs, some of those signs are 10, 11 years old. And I don't know if they're collecting every year.
They're renewing them this year.
So can I entertain a motion to authorize moving forward? And it does have an RFP above, but well, let's come back to the RFP. Let's see what the costs are first, and then we authorize the spending. But is it agreed that if I can raise half of it, that we may be able to support it?
Absolutely.
Raising the spending another half.
This is for this one event,
and I'm going to look to hopefully get sponsorships for other things. Like, I'd love to get a sponsorship for the turf field, which maybe over a 10-year, like, so, you know, over a 10-year period, pay for itself. So, maybe I'm high in the sky, but I mean, if we've got $50,000 a year, but big logo in the middle, you know, it's not the greatest thing, but if we've got $50,000 a year, every 10 years when you have to turn the field over, we'll get the field back and move out. So, things like that is what I'm looking for. But this specific, I'm going to try to do it event by event, so you can say yes or no on each thing.
Okay. So, all right. Yeah. And I'll make a motion that as the chair, Joe, try to get 50% of the funds to pay for the discus cage. And if you can get that $17,000, then the motion would be with as the committee approved $17,000.
Second.
Motion to be made, seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it. Okay, moving to the next. Thank you very much. Moving to the next agenda item. I want to visit this night alternative school. This is a passion of former committee member Connell. I reached out to him because I know the committee was interested in it, even though Mr. Connell was leading the charge. But I did reach out to him and ask him if he was interested in pursuing this. He agreed. So I just wanted to create a subcommittee to determine if, you know, what the costs are, and what we were looking at for is the costs are going to be either state funded or federally funded, so it's not going to be a big impact to the town. But it would create alternative schooling for children, parents, adults, people who maybe can't, even young people can't go to school because of their economic environment. So it opens up opportunities. The purpose of this is just to create a subcommittee and study it, find out what the funding is. It's not that we commit to doing this, but it's. I'd like to ask that the committee support creating this, making Mr. Connell chairman, having two committee members, have a superintendent or his designee, and an additional appointment for the superintendent, so it would be a committee of five. Anybody have any questions on it? In fact, I entertain a motion to create the subcommittee to study and fund a night alternative school with Mr. Connell as the chairman, was interest of Mrs. Mayo, Mr. Jones, putting on the superintendent of his designee and an additional appointment by the superintendent. That motion, I mean, is there a motion?
I would just like to add,
sure.
We ran in Central Falls Parent College every Wednesday night with a series of courses for parents, for retraining for jobs, to learn how to use Chromebooks, everything. So, and it was tremendously successful. So I'm excited about this possibility for this.
Great. Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion to create the subcommittee to study and fund Knight/Alternative School and appoint Mr. William Connell as the chair of that subcommittee.
Second. Motion's been made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? The ayes have it, and two other appointments will be Mrs. Mayo, Mr. Jones, superintendent, his designee, and appointment for the superintendent. Does anybody have any further business before this committee? I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion's been made.
Second.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?